Technology is nowhere near eliminating death. As you suggested, there are biomedical research programs that, at least if they are successful, hold out the promise of extending our lives. But that's still not the same thing as doing away with death. I don't think we are anywhere near being able to do that. Technologically, it's not on the horizon. I mean, even if you let your imagination run wild imagine that advances in medicine allow us to live to be 200, 300, 500. That's still not the same as dying. So one question is, could it be that the case that technology eventually makes it possible to literally not die? And the second is, whether or not that happens, what will it do to our lives if we can postpone death, if we can live a lot longer? Suppose that what we did was we took my brain when my body was about to wear out. We took my brain and put it into a new synthetic body and then hooked up all the neurons the right way and so forth and so on. I'm inclined to think that would be me. Yes, who wakes up after the operation? I'm inclined to think that would be me. So what makes it true, arguably what makes it true that it's Shelley still alive tomorrow is it's the same brain. Okay, so far so good. But suppose the brain is gonna wear out too.
Yes.
And so what we did, what the scientists we imagined doing is we copy all of the thoughts and then put them on a nice new clean brain, a blank brain. It's like uploading all of the Shelley programs, all of the Nadoka programs, like a computer, right? You know, all the data files. But I put on a new hard drive. But is that still then Shelley that wakes up? If the answer is follow the brain, my brain's over there decaying.
Yeah.
This is a new blank brain. Because this is about going to be very sad. When Shelley's brain then, you know, stops functioning, it looks as even though there's this nice new Shelley 2025 model, it's not really Shelley. Yeah. It's an imitation Shelley. Shelley dies. Yeah. Shelley gets buried. Shelley turns into dust. So what it looks as though science can give us is copies of us. But maybe it can't give us us. It can't give us immortality. We fall in love with people because of the properties they have. You know, they're smart, they're pretty, they're generous, they're funny, they're compassionate. But if somebody else comes along that's smarter and prettier and funnier and more intelligent and more compassionate, you don't say, bye-bye, toots, you know, I'm going with them. Because if you did that, you weren't really in love with the first person in the first place. So there's something about being in love where you're in love with that very individual and a copy is not good enough. You know, I think I've been around for 70 years. I'm now picturing myself in the place of the clone, right? I think I've been around for almost 70 years, but in fact, I'm 15 minutes old. You know, I think I have all these memories, all these friends, but in fact, I was never there for any of those things. It's hard to imagine a deeper or worse or more pervasive and systematic lie that you could possibly tell to anybody about anything. And so you've done something horrendously wrong to the clone in effectively brainwashing them this way. So morally, if somebody wants to do that with pets, I think I'm okay. I mean, there's no issues about animal rights, but I think they're probably not relevant here. If you want to do that with their pets, that's okay. They want to do that with another human, yeah, that's probably wrong.